Angela is slowly coming out of her nostalgic state. She is awakened, she's breathing deeply, she's sweating, but she's confined to a bed and she can only sit up so far. And she can see that she has something in her arm, in her veins. And she's looking around to see where she is. And then we see a shot of Miss Lady True in a seat. And she looks at Angela and says, "Oh, well, hi there. Welcome back." And that is the end of the episode. Once again, I thought this episode was absolutely amazing. The cinematography alone deserves an applause. The deep, dark shots panning us in and out, seeing visuals that represent thoughts in the background, the colors, the blacks, the red, the yellows, very beautiful. When there were splashes of red, it was against this dark contrast. Absolutely amazing. You weren't confused at any time about what year it was. Going, flipping back and forth to present and back in the 30s and back in the 60s and back. That's good writing, people. That is good cinematography. That is good planning, to where you are not confused as the audience, reminding us who's who, reminding us of what we saw in previous episodes. Now, a lot of people were hesitant and talked trash about it on YouTube, other YouTubers. I peeped game about what other people were saying, and I was saying the exact opposite of pretty much everybody, saying, I don't think that this is gonna be a bad show, because a lot of people were hesitant and judging it on, of course, the director of Lost, okay? And those of you who watch Lost, it was this continuous, what? Who is this and what happened? Then we had to wait every week to find out what the heck was going on. In this instance with the first and second episode, it was different. It gave us very important, intricate details, and not to the fact to where we were confused. You weren't confused at any time about what year it was. Yeah, it was very clear. It was very evident. And you weren't confused even with going back and forth and back and forth with imagery that we saw in previous episodes. That is great writing, you guys, okay? That is good cinematography blended together to where we can understand everything. We say, oh yeah, that was in the last episode. Oh yes, this person. That is very difficult because you have so many characters at one time. Had they force fed us everybody at one time, it would have been trash. It would have been pure trash if they would have showed an image of somebody and then put the name at the bottom. I'm like, oh, that's that person. Oh, that's Adrian. You know, oh, that's, you know, that would have sucked. Then I would have been like, I'm out. I'm not watching this anymore. But the fact that it led us on and it pulled us in and it makes you think. People get very frustrated when they have to wait and when they have to think. But this, to me, was worth the wait. And it allowed me to think on my own. Who could this person be in the hood? Who is that? If you've read the comic books, you did have a very good idea of who's who. But I wanted to look at the series as if I'm someone who hadn't seen the movie, who hadn't read the comic books. So with that in mind, it's very good. And now people are starting to say, oh, wait, I like the show. Oh my God, it's good. Okay. You know, y'all sleep on your girl. It's okay. It's all right. I know y'all, I'm new to YouTube, you know, but I've always been a movie buff and I've always been a person who's loved intricate series. I still brag that I predicted the ending to Game of Thrones to a T. All of the proof is on my Instagram page. Follow me on Instagram at the same profile name, official_bun_E. I guessed who would be king. I guessed what would happen to who. I mean, because I based it up on making educated guesses of what was what. Now, a lot of people weren't happy with season 8. I was one of them, but it came to an end and there's nothing we can do about it. And those years are over and done. All we can look forward to are the prequels, which I will review in 2020. I'm so excited. But anywho, back to Watchmen. I hope that you enjoyed it. I hope that you were patient and allowed the story to develop and grow. Now, some of you are still saying, girl, after episode 6, I'm still like, what the heck, and I still don't like it. Now would be a good time to tap out. If you are not feeling it now and we're almost done with this season, this show may not be for you because we only have 3 episodes left. And they did that on purpose. They gave us 9 because season 2 has to pull you in. It's HBO, y'all. They're trying to build something here. So I love it. I think it's great. Let me know what you think. Comment, subscribe. You watching me? I know you watching. You want to see my opinion. It's people that come on my page, get my notes, get my details, and they take it back to their page. I see you. It's okay. But subscribe. And I don't know if you notice, I subscribe to whomever subscribes to me. It's all good. I'll see you next week. We're all caught up now. Thank you for being patient. Last week, I lost my voice and I could not record a thing. So, you know, I was so frustrated, but we are back to our scheduled programming, people, and we are back in line and everything's gonna come like it's supposed to come. Thank you for being patient as I played the catch-up game with last week's episode. We are back, okay? See you guys next week. Make sure to check out other reviews on the channel. No need to dig around. Go straight to the playlist. I'll see you next time. Bye.